Imagine if your alerts didn't just notify you, but also appeared right on your dashboard. This tutorial will show you how to link alerts directly to Grafana, making every incident visible exactly where its data lives. You will react way faster if an alert gives you the bigger picture, getting the supporting data right there on a chart to see exactly when and why the event happened. It's very convenient. You can take this tutorial however you like, in our interactive learning environment or Grafana OSS locally. All options include Grafana, Prometheus, and a Python app simulating CPU and memory, so you can watch alerts fire in real time. Okay, first, let's build the visualization. Go to Dashboards and create a new dashboard. I will add a time series visualization, and I will use Prometheus as the data source. Prometheus scrapes the metrics that I'm exposing from my Python script. It simulates random CPU and memory usage values from 10% to 100% every 10 seconds. So first I will pull in the CPU usage metric with the following PromQL query. This query should display the simulated CPU usage data for the prod environment. Next, I will add a second query for the memory usage metric. Note that the metric is now Flask app memory usage. Nice, we've got two lines right there in one panel, which gives us an instant view of system health and how those signals connect. Next, I'm creating another rule that watches CPU and fires when it crosses 75%. I will name it CPU usage. For that, I'm using the same PromQL query that returns the CPU usage in prod. I will set 75 as the value for when query is above to set the threshold for the alert. If I click preview alert rule condition, I can see the query returns the CPU usage of the Flask application in the production environment. Next, I will create a folder to store my alerts, which I will name system metrics. I will also need to set the evaluation behavior. Click new evaluation group and give it a name. For example, system usage. Choose an evaluation interval, for example, 1 minute, which means how often the alert will be evaluated. Then set pending period to 0 seconds, so the alert rule fires the moment the condition is met. And keep firing for also to 0 seconds, so the alert stops firing immediately after the condition is no longer true. This minimizes the waiting time for the demonstration. Next, I'm linking it to an existing contact point. For a quick test, you can use a public webhook to capture and inspect alert notifications. And finally, I'm linking the alert to the visualization we created earlier. So when the alert fires, Grafana drops an annotation at the exact moment of the breach. Save the alert rule and let's take a look at our dashboard now. Here is the result. After the alert rule is linked to a visualization, you should see health indicators on the panel. A red heart icon when the alert is in alerting state, and a green heart when in normal state. In addition, you should also get annotations, which provide helpful context, such as the time the alert was triggered. Moreover, the default notification should now include two buttons, View Dashboard and View Panel. Click either and Grafana opens with the right time window already applied. If you want to define a more intentional time range, you can customize your notifications using a notification template. With a template, you can explicitly set from and to values for a more precise control. To learn more about using templates, check our dedicated tutorial. And that's it, you have connected alerting with a visualization. Every alert now tells a clear story, when it happened, what it impacted, and when it recovered, all in one place. If you enjoyed this, explore the rest of the alerting series at grafana.com/tutorials. There are more parts packed with tips to build cleaner and more actionable alerts. Thanks for watching.